Good evening. Welcome to Young and Successful. We have Miss Shyrell Hobson with us tonight.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks for coming out. And she has a wonderful book called Seams of Gold. We're about to talk about her, So let's just go right in and let people know who you are.
Hi, I'm Shyrell Hobson. I'm an author, speaker, fitness instructor, and resilience coach.
You're a jack of all trades. All of the above.
Absolutely.
Yes, yes. So let's talk about your book. Like, you know, being an author, how is that process? Is it extensive? I've never done it before. How does that work out?
Well, being an author is something that has been placed in my path recently. Prior to becoming an author, I was just into fitness, doing athletics. I was a coach. And it was came to that moment where I wanted to be free, and I wanted to free myself from the misconception of what beauty looks like. And so I had always spoke to people, and people said, oh, have you ever thought about writing a book? And I'm like, no, I don't have time to sit and write a book. And what ended up happening when I decided to surrender and be obedient to the feelings that I was having, I decided I was going to start to write. And doing that through obedience, everything else aligned with me. So I ended up having a mentor, someone who wanted to walk me through it and actually birth my book. And so I just remained on track with that and decided to drop it.
Something key that you said is that you had a mentor. I don't know if a lot of you all, if you do or do not have a mentor, but that is essential to increasing and improving your professional development. You always want to have a mentor that can help you out and help you miss those obstacles and challenges they might have had to go through and get that wisdom from them.
And I think that we have to be okay with not knowing everything, right? I enjoy being around people that have different gifts. I know what my gifts are, and it is not, you know, it's not very creative. I can't draw, I can't sing.
Me either.
But I have a mind that is out of this world, and so I link up with people that have that specialize in their gifts, and then you create a team, and so everybody wins because everyone is doing what their gift is.
And that's great, because it's kind of like how they say, you know, you don't want yes men, so you don't want your circle to be all the same type of people, type A people, or all the same, you know, characteristics. You want people around you that can push you, that can challenge you, and help you think about new and innovative ideas that you might have not thought of yourself, because that might not be your gift.
Right, absolutely. And I think that you just have to be okay with embracing that and being okay with people saying, well, maybe you should try it like this, or maybe you should try it like that. And so I've just been very blessed and honored to have people that are in my circle who genuinely care about me and my well-being and who are willing to put the time into making sure that it's successful.
So speaking about circle, because as you're going through different stages in life and different entrepreneur objectives, how critical is it to have a good circle? And how did you, because I'm sure your circle had to eventually change.
Absolutely.
You had to release some people and add some people. So what is that process like? Because it can be hard, you know, if you have someone that you've always been friends with, close with, to separate yourself.
Absolutely. Well, one thing that I know for me, when you are walking in purpose, or when you are being obedient, you don't have to... You don't have to worry about as much of getting rid of people. They kind of fall off themselves. And then the other people come on board that want to see you be successful. So I haven't had to have, you know, that many conversations with removing people or so forth. They kind of fall off by themselves. And so that's been a blessing. And that was a reason why I decided to become a resilience coach, because I feel like people, we are attracted to, you're attracted to the space that you're in.
Right.
So when you are in a broken place, you attract broken people.
Mm.
When you're successful, you attract successful people.
Mm-hmm.
When you're loving, you attract loving people. And so I try to go back and make sure that I'm in the right space so that I can attract the right people.
So I like what you said. You go back and make sure that you're right. So it's all right to self-reflect. Sometimes we need to genuinely look into the mirror and see, are we the person that we really think we are?
Mm-hmm.
And kind of self-reflect kind of goes into your book. Like, let's talk about your book and everything.
So Seams of Gold, Discovering Beauty and Brokenness. I came up with that title based on a Japanese method that they use called kintsugi. And kintsugi is where they take shattered broken pieces of pottery, and they repair it with gold.
Wow.
And then they sell it, and then it's more valuable, you know, once it's been sealed or filled,
right,
than it was when it was just broken or whole. So you'll see in the back of the book, that's a picture of kintsugi here.
Very intriguing.
And so that's what I thought of my life of being. You know, instead of filling myself, instead of covering myself with gold. And when I think of covering yourself with gold, that's avoiding the issues, that's putting up a front that we're okay.
Right.
It's, you know, living up to the image that people expect us
putting
to have.
Putting a big wall
putting
up.
Putting a wall up.
But broken
that's,
on the inside.
That's covering yourself with gold. But I decided to fill myself with gold so that I can embrace the current place that I was in, whether it was broken, whether it was happy, whether it was peaceful, wherever I was at, I decided I was going to embrace that current place.
Wow.
Because that's what I felt made me beautiful.
That's marvelous. A lot of time we are not that intuitive,
mm-hmm.
you know, or organic with ourselves to realize that and accept where we are and then turn around and focus on leveraging that. So I think that's very amazing. Let people know where they can find your book,
okay.
how they can buy it, how they can contact you if they want you to come out and sign a book. Let everyone know how they can reach you.
Well, I'm definitely open to book signings, any kind of small women's group or big women's group, doesn't matter, anybody. I focus on resilience. I focus on balance and fitness. They can find me at Shyrell Hobson. So www.shyrellhobson.com. And there you will find all my upcoming events. You will find how to contact me as far as social media. I'm open to traveling, so I definitely would love to go global.
Good.
I have a tour that is coming up called the Resilient Woman Tour.
Nice.
And so we will be traveling all over the place, and that's also in the making, so you can find that on ShyrellHobson.com.
Well, look, make sure you all follow her, support her. She's doing some amazing things, and I am a true fan of making sure that you build inside and then it will manifest out. Just talking about inside and having issues and embracing really who you are,
mm-hmm.
how is, like, what are the difficulties with doing that or, you know, coming up, being an entrepreneur with your own book? Like, what are some trials and tribulations that you had to overcome?
I think that we all talk about time, you know, not having enough time.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel that if it's something that's going to benefit you and others, then you make time.
Mm.
And so I decided I make time. I hustle now, and I'll be able to enjoy it later. And
right.
my joy comes from seeing other people be resilient in their difficult times. So I don't feel like this is a time to rest. I think with all the things that we have going on currently, this is a time to move.
Mm.
And so I find my motivation from just the challenges. Every time I see that there's people that are going through difficult times, that's just another boost for me to know that it's time to get to work.
Wow.
So I would always suggest to people to pay attention to the pull and not the push. And what I mean by that is there are going to be people that are going to push you to what they feel and think that you should be doing.
Right.
But it's that one thing that's going to pull you back, that you think about when you're asleep, that you think about when you're driving your car. Those are the signs that you should pay attention to.
That is so brilliant, so intriguing, and I love those words of wisdom. We appreciate it. Well, it's been fun. It's been great. Thank you again for coming out
Thank
with
you.
Us. And don't forget, you all, July 15th from 3 to 7 p.m., we will have Houston Gospel Fest, and we will see you the same time, same place next week on Young and Successful.